The great hall of the house was in darkness. William stood on the gallery landing and pointed his torch over and down into the space below. He moved the beam slowly round the room until it came to rest on the centre of the huge brick fireplace. The canopy over the opening was decorated with carved brickwork. There were dragons curling and catching at their tails, and two snakes climbing up a stick that stood above the dragons and seemed to have been planted between them. On one side of the snake stick, a fat sun was carved with rays that stretched out over the brick wall. On the other side of the snake stick, a crescent moon was carved. William was surprised to see this brick picture. He was sure he should have noticed it before, but couldn't understand why he hadn't, unless he thought it's something to do with the way the beam of light is falling on it. Perhaps it's only visible in torchlight and from up here. I must remember to look in the morning. He walked carefully along the gallery to the head of the broad stairs that led down to the ground floor. At first, the silence of the sleeping house was overwhelming. But as he listened, innumerable small sounds came into his hearing. The clock ticking in the kitchen.